ద ఫోర్స్ యాక్టింగ్ అనే ఫోర్స్ యాక్టింగ్ అనే కరెంట్ క్యారియింగ్ కండక్టర్ కరెంట్ క్యారియింగ్ కండక్టర్ ప్లేస్డ్ ఇన్ ఏ యూనిఫామ్ మ్యాగ్నెటిక్ ఫీల్డ్ నెక్స్ట్ టాపిక్ ఈస్ ఫోర్స్ యాక్టింగ్ అనే కరెంట్ క్యారియింగ్ కండక్టర్ ప్లేస్డ్ ఇన్ ద యూనిఫామ్ మ్యాగ్నెటిక్ ఫీల్డ్ Now, this is the current carrying conductor. This is the current carrying conductor. This is the current carrying conductor. Right? What is the area of the conductor? A. What is the length of the conductor? L. What is the current passing through the conductor? I. What is the magnetic field? This is the magnetic field. This magnetic field B is making an angle theta with respect to the magnetic field. Now, this is called current carrying conductor. Now, already we said two magnetic fields are there, there is a force. Now, here, this is the external magnetic field. Around the current carrying conductor, right? Around the current carrying conductor, there is an induced magnetic field. Induced magnetic field. External magnetic field is there and induced magnetic fields are there. Then there is a force. Now that force is F bar is equals to I into that is L bar cross B bar. That force, a current carrying conductor is placed in the uniform magnetic field, then that conductor will experience a force that is F bar is equals to I bar, I into L bar cross B bar, I into that is L bar cross B bar. Now here in this case, the force is a vector quantity. It has a magnitude and it has the direction. Force magnitude F is equals to I. A bar cross B bar is equals to AB sin theta. L bar cross B bar that equals to LB sin theta. Direction can be determined by Fleming's left hand rule. Right? Now I want to prove this equation. Now, here in this case, whenever the current is passing through a conductor is there. Current is passing, right? Current is passing means electrons are traveling with what speed? Electrons are traveling with a drift speed. Therefore, here current density J is equals to what to say? I by A is equals to NEVD. Therefore, what is I? I is equals to NEA, that is VD. This is called first equation. Already we said there is a conductor. Through the conductor, current is passing. Current is passing means the charges are moving. What charges are moving? Electrons are moving. With what speed electrons are moving? They are traveling with the drift speed. What is the definition of the drift speed? Already I told you, we discussed. Therefore, the constant speed acquired by the electrons when the current is passing through the conductor is called drift speed. In that case, therefore, I is equals to NEAVD. What is N? Number of charge carriers per unit volume. N is the number of charge carriers per unit volume. E is the electronic charge. A is the area of cross section. VD is the drift velocity. Now, here in this case, current carrying conductor is there. Current is there. The charges are there. What charge is there? Now electron is there. Now let us consider here. An electron is moving, right? In a conductor, which is placed in a uniform magnetic field. Then F is equals to, what is the formula? That is F is equals to Q into V bar. Our general formula is equals to F is equals to Q into, right, V bar cross B bar. Now this is called, what to say, F, general formula. Now current carrying conductor is there, current is passing, the charges are moving. Which charges are moving? Electrons are moving. As the electron is moving in the magnetic field, external magnetic field, then it will experience a force. With what speed it is moving? With a drift speed it is moving. Now electron, this is the Q, electron is moving with a drift speed V in a magnetic field. Then such electron will experience a force. F is equals to electron. What is the speed? Drift speed, right? Drift velocity, V bar cross B bar. This is called, what to say, right? Now here, now in the conductor, in a small length element, the total length element is equals to L. Total length element is L. Therefore, now here, what is the length element? DL is the length. Now here, the force experienced by, right, all electrons in a DL element. Then this is, let us consider, this is the conductor. Total length is equals to L. In a small length element, there are so many number of electrons. Now, here in this case, how many number of electrons in a small length? Right? Now, number of electrons per unit volume is equals to N. Number of electrons per unit volume is N. Next, number of electrons in a DL volume, right, N into volume is equals to how much? N into volume is equals to area into length, A into DL, right? Here in this case, right, the force experienced by a single charge electron. Now the force experienced by all the charges, The force experienced by all the electrons in a DL element, only DL element. The force experienced by only DL element. The force experienced by all the electrons in a DL element is equals to, right? The force experienced by single charge into number of electrons in a, right, DL volume.